Preauricular sinuses are common congenital malformations first described in 1864 by Heusinger. They are frequently noted on routine examination as small dells adjacent to the external ear, usually at the anterior margin of the ascending limb of the helix. Preauricular sinuses are inherited as an incomplete autosomal dominant pattern with reduced penetrance and variable power of expression. They can arise spontaneously and may be bilateral in 25-50% of cases. Bilateral sinuses are more likely to be hereditary. In unilateral cases, the left side is more commonly affected. During embryogenesis, the auricle arises from the first and second branchial arches during the 6th week of gestation. The first and second branchial arch each gives rise to 3 hillocks, namely the hillocks of His. 3 hillocks arise from the caudal border of the first branchial arch and 3 arise from the cephalic border of the second branchial arch. These hillocks should unite during the next few weeks of embryogenesis. Preauricular sinuses are thought to occur as a result of incomplete fusion of these hillocks. Preauricular sinuses are usually narrow and vary in length. Usually they are very short and their orifices are usually minute. They may arborize and follow a tortuous course in the immediate vicinity of the external ear. The morbidity associated with preauricular sinuses include recurrent infections at the site, ulceration, scarring, pyoderma, and facial cellulitis. Specifically, the following conditions may occur: abscesses at and anterior to the involved ear, chronic and recurrent drainage from sinus orifices, and malar ulceration, otitis externa, and unilateral facial cellulitis. It has been suggested that initial fistula probing serves as a surgical guide, and further methylene blue injection helps to avoid leaving viable squamous epithelial remnants. This viable squamous epithelial remnant left behind during surgery can lead to recurrences. Some believe that the sinus tract should be surgically extirpated in patients who are asymptomatic, because the onset of symptoms and subsequent infection cause scarring, which may lead to incomplete removal of the sinus tract and postoperative recurrences. The recurrence rate after surgery is 13-42% and 21% in one large study. During surgery, some surgeons use either a probe or an injection of methylene blue dye for cannulation of the orifice. The most successful method is to use both modalities to delineate the entire tract and remove it.